Yeah, yeah, let him go into the car.
Oh, we got one down.
Boulder is a windy place with wind over 50 and 60 miles an hour in many days during the winter. In some cases, they reach 90 and 100 miles an hour, making Boulder a perfect sport for wind energy testing.
Behind me is a wind technology center belongs to National Renewable Energy Laboratory. There are a lot of wind farms constructed around the United States, like here. They indicate the promising future of this industry.
Boulder and many other areas around the U.S. possesses plenty of wind sources, but wind energy is expensive and predictable. Those are big problems.
The biggest problem with wind is that it is intermittent in that the wind doesn't blow all the time, so you don't get energy from the wind all the time.
Currently, wind energy, with very few exceptions, means there are locations where wind energy is actually really competitive. But in general, wind energy is right now not competitive money-wise, so you need to have some form of a stimulus or subsidy.
Generating electricity is one thing, but it's another problem getting it to people's homes.
And it's also their distribution problems, because we don't have enough distribution in the places like the northern Great Plains, where there's a lot of wind.
Because of those issues, power companies are reluctant to invest money in wind projects, especially in today's fragile economy.
A wind turbine, a 2.5 megawatt wind turbine, is in the million of dollar range. If I can tell essentially the bank with great certainty how much energy and what the value of the energy is that the wind farm produces, the lower is the risk.
Given climate change, reducing oil reliance, renewables like wind and solar may play a key role in the future. The American Wind Energy Association reports in Colorado alone, wind power production could create up to 6,000 new jobs. By 2035, the state hopes to raise wind energy production up to 30%. Eric Wang, Newsteam Boulder.